5 years since we started doing the show here at Megaplex? I can't really believe it either. And in fact, I can't believe it's been my 10-year anniversary hosting the show, both here at Megaplex and in the sleepy little town that I'm from. Well, to celebrate 5 years here at Megaplex, we have a great show for you today. We've got three great contestants in the way of Riley, Nihilus, and Percy. We've got great prizes for you, the studio audience, and for them. And we even have a very special surprise prize for whoever wins our game today. So, good luck to the three of you. Let's get to work here on the Jeopardy ground. There's one daily double hidden somewhere in these six categories. All About You, a category devoted to this year's convention theme. What the font? I'm a Disney princess. Furry crossword clues. The Beatles. And finally, have you heard of the critically acclaimed MMORPG Final Fantasy XIV? You have the free trial up to level 60 and the award-winning expansion Heavensward. Percy, you are in the player one seat, so you get to pick first from any one of these categories.
Let's get it over with. Final Fantasy 14,000.
For 1,000, her shrewd merchant dealings in the House of Splendors have made her one of the richest in Eorzea. Make sure your buzzman is working. Tap it one more time. Here. It's a new thing this year. Is it working?
It's working.
Well, technical difficulties are great. Okay.
We're just not tapping.
Yeah, we're not buzzing yet.
All right, well, let's just go to raising hands then. Technical problems are wonderful.
Are you trying to buzz
in? No, we're not buzzing.
That's what I thought was going on. We're just not trying to buzz in.
Well, you don't know that? Okay. All right, well, it's a live show. Things happen. Okay, I didn't think we'd get to this point this soon. So, what we have for you, the studio audience, is little prizes. In this green box right over here, we have some audience prizes. So, audience, what do you think the correct response is? And shout it out loud.
Rowena!
Yes, come on up. Right here to this green box. Please only take one. Okay. Nobody gets that. Percy, you are still in control. Let's go again.
Let's try Beatles, 1,000.
Beatles for 1,000. Although this song can be abbreviated to LSD, Lennon stated the song was actually inspired by a drawing of his sons. Percy?
What is Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds?
Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, that's correct.
Beatles 800. Beatles for 800.
For 800. Assemble in unison, right now, over me, and tell me if the words in this 1969 song have any meaning. Percy?
What is Come Together?
Yes, Come Together.
Same category, 600.
For 600, this song appeared on the album of the same name, the final album produced by the Beatles as a whole. Nihilus?
What is Let It Be?
Yes.
Let's do Fonts for 800.
For 800, also the name of an egotistical skeleton from Undertale. Percy?
What is Papyrus?
Correct.
Beatles 400.
For 400. It was one of the songs performed during their appearance on the Ed Sullivan Show. Did Ed understand when they said that something? Anybody? Okay, audience, do you know your Beatles songs? Yes, that's correct. Nobody gets that. Percy, you're still in control of the board.
Let's do end the category for 200.
For 200. McCartney wrote this song to comfort John Lennon during his divorce. It later became the Beatles' best performing U.S. single. Nobody? Throw it to the audience.
What is Hey Jude?
Hey Jude is correct. Come on up. We are now done with the Beatles. Percy, you're still in control. Let's go somewhere else.
All right, let's go to Fonts for 1,000.
Double. Now, Percy, you have 2,600 you put at risk. You may risk any or all of it. What would you like to do?
Let's risk 1,000.
1,000 points for a new total of 3,600 if you are correct. Here is the clue for you. Designed to mimic a typewriter of days gone by, its name is also a word used to describe one who delivers letters and packages.
What is courier?
Courier is correct.
All right, keep going. Fonts for 600.
For this clue, it was used as the default font in Google's Android operating system and is also the name of a Spitz track. Domo arigato, Mr. Percy.
What is Roboto?
Roboto is correct.
All right. Fonts for 400.
For 400. This rather striking font was probably used to make your favorite image macro. Bottom text, right?
What is Impact?
Impact is correct. You control the font.
Font 200?
Font for 200. This font was first released in 1995 with Microsoft 3D Movie Maker and has been a plague upon typography ever since. Percy?
What is Comic Sans?
Comic Sans is correct.
Alright, how about we try All About You for 600?
All About You for, could you repeat the value?
For 600.
For 600. Of the softwoods, the genus Taxus, or this common name, is the hardest. I think we have another audience question. What do you think it is? You is correct. Come on up. Percy, you think again.
All right. How about Disney Princess for 1,000?
Disney Princess for 1,000. Be our guest and tell us the name of this bibliophile French woman. Percy?
Who is Belle?
Belle is correct.
All right. Princess for 800.
Disney's 12th official princess, she hails from the village of Montanui, who was chosen to restore the heart of Tahiti. Percy?
Who is Moana?
Moana is correct.
All right, princess for 600?
For 600. Salakadoodle, Menchikaboodle, Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo. Put them together and what have you got? This princess who lost her shoe. This is a gimme. Audience? One at a time. Whoever said it first, come on up, get yourself a prize. All right, Percy.
All right. Sorry, what's that fourth category again?
The fourth category?
Yes.
Is furry crossword clues.
Let's do that for 1,000.
Furry crossword clues for 1,000. An emoticon typically associated with surprise or intrigue. Three letters. Percy?
What is OWO?
We would also have accepted OWO. What's this?
Let's try crossword clues for 800.
For 800. Megaplex's mascot, six letters. Riley?
Who is Pounce?
Pounce is correct. You control it.
Hurry for 400.
For 400. Common name for a female Canis Vulpes, five letters. Percy?
What is it, Dixon?
Correct.
Let's do All About You, 1,000.
All About You for 1,000. He was introduced in the video game Persona 4 as a mostly silent protagonist. Where are my anime fans? You, Narukami. Narukami, yes, that's correct. Come on up and get yourself a prize. Percy?
All right, let's try you 800.
You for 800. Her scientific name is Ovis Aries. Her common name is this. Audience?
You
is correct. Come and get a prize. Percy?
Furry crossword, 600.
For 600. A manufacturer of electric guitars, also for Affinity's mascot. Six letters. Nihilus?
What is Fender?
Fender is correct.
Let's finish off furry crossword clues for 200.
For 200, long-distance canon communication, four letters. Percy?
What is AWU?
AWU is correct.
AWU!
That category, let's go somewhere else.
All right, Disney Princess, 400.
For 400 in Disney Princess. In Hans Christian Andersen's original tale, she dies and dissolves into seafoam. In Disney's reimagining, she marries her prince. Percy?
Who is Ariel?
Ariel's correct.
All right, Princess 200.
Princess for 200. She was taken to a whole new world by Prince Ali, Fabulous He, Ali Ababa. Percy?
Who is Princess Jasmine?
Jasmine is correct.
All right, back to you for 400.
You for 400. Merriam-Webster defines this pronoun as the one or ones being addressed. In the South, one might say y'all. Percy?
Who is you?
Yes.
All right, you 200.
When abbreviating the name of a prestigious college, you might shorten the word university to this single vowel. Nihilus?
What is you?
I think we finally figured out the trick to that category. Well done. Nihilus, we have four clues left in the Final Fantasy XIV category. Where would you like to start?
Nowhere on this one, but let's do 800.
For 200. Lifted from Final Fantasy X, these feline men in Final Fantasy XIV hail from Ulsebar. Percy?
What are the Hrothgar?
Yes, that's correct.
All right, so let's do 800.
For 800? Hailing from Ivalice, these Lapine ladies were first teased in Stormblood and made playable in Shadowrunners. Where are my Final Fantasy XII fans? Viera, come on, get one. Come and get a little prize.
All right, let's try 600.
For 600. In the English translation, his final words were, a smile better suits a hero.
You will die.
And he wouldn't want you to be sad. Who is he?
Yes!
We have one clue left in the Final Fantasy XIV category. Let's take a look at it. He attempted to call upon the power of the Twelve to save the realm from Bahamut, and ultimately became bound to him. All right, who is he?
Deathwing!
Who is Louis Swa?
Louis Swa, yes! All right, then. Well, all right. Well, that does it for our Jeopardy round. Let's take a look at the scores. Percy, absolutely dominating with 9,000 points out there. And Nihilus and Riley, 1,400 and 1,200, respectfully. We're going to take a few minutes. Let's get set up for Double Jeopardy, and then we'll be right back, and we'll learn about our players. Take a break, why don't you? Something fun to do tonight, and you don't want to go to a DJ concert tonight, why not show up tonight and tomorrow night at 8:30 in tournaments for our Furry Idol Showcase. If you like live singing performances, this is the event to go to. We had two great performers last night on Furry Idol, Birds and Shonday, who won our competition. Birds will be singing for you tonight in tournaments, 8:30, and Shonday, Sunday at 8:30 as well, and after the Furry Idol Showcase performances, it will be your turn. We'll open up the mic to anyone who wants to sing karaoke. So come on down to tournaments at 8:30 for our Furry Idol Showcase and furryoke. It's going to be a great time. We're going to go until like 1 a.m. or something like that. So join us for that. And now let's take some time to meet our contestants. We have Riley Winters here, first of all, who is a weatherman from Denver, Colorado.
Hello!
So you're the one that we need to blame when it's a nice sunny day outside and we want to go on vacation and then it's nothing but storms, right?
Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
Well, it's okay, it's okay. What's your station call sign?
So I used to work for WJAC out in central Pennsylvania.
All right. If there's any Pennsylvania furs out there, you may have seen this guy on TV giving you the weather. I also have here that you have a DJ set going on tonight. You want to tell us about that and
Correct.
What you're on?
Yes, 11 p.m. tonight here on main stage. I will be doing a set pop nostalgia 80s to now. I guarantee you'll be nostalgic during it.
All right. Make sure you show up for Riley's DJ set tonight in the main ballroom. We move now to Nihilus Coyote, a software support specialist. He is an anchor baby. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so I was born here in Florida, but I moved up to Toronto when I was 3 months old, so that's why I'm originally from there, and that's where I lived for most of my life, but I moved down here back to Florida about 6 years ago so I could sponsor my parents for green cards. So I'm the kind of person that Donald Trump really hates.
Well, it's great that you finally come down here all the way from Canada. Do you remember, though, you were born here and then you went to Canada? When did you come down here? Was it a shock for you to come from the Great White North down to this sweltering heat?
My grandparents had a place down in Boca Raton, so I would come down here as a kid, so I was kind of used to it.
Oh, you're used to it.
Well, I was born here, so sort of in my blood in a way.
All right. Well, we're glad to have you. Our final player today, our first player today, is an insurance mail clerk from Tampa, Florida. It's Percy, and you have 7 cats. Why?
Don't blame me. Me and my parents are all suckers. Whenever a stray cat shows up at our door, it is now our cat.
Well, it's great that you're taking care of them. Can you recite all their names by memory?
Oh, yes. We've got... We first adopted Mama Kitty and Two Socks. They came into our house to take shelter from a storm, like a movie. Next, we adopted Skeeter and Mr. Man. And then off the streets, we got Pumpkin, Cheetah, and Buddy.
All right, great. It's great that you're taking care of them. And that's Percy Cotter, everybody. Now, we are going to get set up for the Double Jeopardy round. Who's in third place? Riley, you will be picking first from these 6 categories. The Return of Florida Man. What's My Number? Board Games. Weird Al Songs. The Beatles. Notice the spelling. And finally...
Hi, I'm Fo. And how about some Fulbury Opery?
Any 6 categories, 2 daily doubles. Where are we starting?
Let's do Florida Man 800.
For 800. In 1981, Konami released this arcade game in which you guide an amphibian.
Yeah. Florida Man.
Yeah, he said Florida Man. For 800. Yeah. Okay. We got off on the wrong one. I heard 800.
Yeah, that's the second click down, not the fourth one.
Yeah. I'm still in first joke. Traveling the world is one item you might put on this to do before you die list. A Monroe County woman had to be arrested on hers in 2022. Nihilus?
What is a bucket list?
Yes.
Let's stick with Florida Man for 1200.
For 1200. An Islamorada, Florida man had a brush with the law when he was caught shoplifting and dumping these dental hygiene products into the Long Key Channel. Percy?
What is a toothbrush?
A toothbrush.
Let's do a Florida Man 1600.
For 1600. In 1981, Konami released this arcade game in which you guide an amphibian across a road. In 2022, a Florida man played the game in real life on I-95. Riley.
What is Frogger?
Frogger. That's correct.
Let's do a Florida Man 2000.
For 2000. In 2020, a Florida man became the first person with Down syndrome to complete this triathlon, which shares its name with an Avenger. Nihilus?
What is the Iron Man?
Yes.
And let's finish the category for 400.
For 400. A Bay County man took this idiom for saving on television costs to the extreme when he was witnessed disabling the satellites of Panama City TV station WJHG. Percy?
What is cutting the cable?
Yes, we'll accept that. We're done with that. Let's go somewhere else.
Let's try Weird Al for 2000.
Weird Al for 2000. This 11-minute ballad about a New Mexico city begins with sauerkraut and ends with sauerkraut. Percy?
What is Albuquerque?
Yes.
All right, Weird Al 1600.
For 1600. Coolio initially described this 1996 rap as having desecrated his original. In 2014, Coolio said he was wrong and the parody was actually funny. Nihilus?
What is Amish Paradise?
Correct.
Weird Al 1200.
For 1200. Madonna herself suggested this 1985 parody set in a real hospital with a real lion, too. Percy?
What is Like a Surgeon?
Correct.
Let's try Beatles 2000.
You might nickname this beetle Bambi, whose jaws are so named for resembling cervine antlers. Where's my insect lovers? A stag beetle, come and get it. No points for that one, but Percy, you're still in control.
All right, let's try Beatles 1600.
For 1600. This beetle can't make you any jewelry out of aurum, but it still has a 24-karat luster all the same. What are we talking about? No, no, no. More specific? No. Anybody else? No. The correct response was a goldsmith beetle. You were on the right track, but it's a goldsmith beetle. Percy?
Let's try Fopery 2000.
Fopery for 2000. Here's Fope.
Holy hell! Anarchy Chess wants you to Google this move, where a pawn can capture an enemy pawn that passes it in a specific way.
Percy?
What is en passant?
Correct.
All right, Fopery 1600.
Give me a chance at karaoke, and I'm likely to be belting songs from this group, such as I Don't Know What We're Talking About and Cool Patrol.
Someone out there has to know this one. All of you know it. Unfortunately, I don't have enough prizes to give out to the entire audience, so whoever shouted it out loudest, come and get it. Come and get it.
We're nerds, we don't know.
Yes. No points for that one, but we're going to move on to the next one.
Let's try Beatles 1200.
Beatles for 1200. Much like the African mammal of the same name, this beetle's defining feature is its long horn. Riley?
What is a rhinoceros beetle?
We'll accept that, yes.
Let's do Potpourri 1200.
You may have caught me and over 15,000 others getting down to the dances at this VR-only furry convention.
Percy?
What is virality?
Virality is correct. And if you don't know by now, our guest of honor here at Megaplex is Whisperer's very famous app, Ferality, and the Ferality Gateway is also here at Megaplex. So if you want to see what Ferality is all about, make sure you check your paper program guide and get into Ferality. It is amazing. Percy, you gave us that last correct response. Let's go somewhere.
Let's try Games 2000.
Games for 2000. Later turned into an electronic toy, this simple game has one person think of a person, place, or thing, while the other person asks 20 questions to figure it out. Riley?
What is 20 questions?
Yes.
Let's do game 16.
Can't sleep? Tracking these fluffy critters might relax you into falling asleep. You never done it before? Riley?
What is sheep? Counting sheep.
Say that one more time.
What is counting sheep?
Counting sheep, yes.
Let's do games 1200.
The answer there. Damn, double. Now, you've got 7,600 you can put at risk. How much would you like to wager?
Let's do 2,000.
2,000 it is for 10,600 if you are correct. 9,600, excuse me. All right, here is the clue for you. Have a noun of a time with this adjective word game verb by Leonard Stern and Roger Price.
What is Mad Libs?
What is Mad Libs? That's correct. And you go to 9600 and pick again.
Let's do games 800.
For 800, look around the room and tell me a single word about what you see in this rhyming object guessing game. Percy?
What is I Spy?
I Spy is correct.
Let's close out the category, 400.
When on a long car trip, see how many Volkswagens you spot by playing this game. Riley?
What is Punch Buggy?
Punch Buggy is correct. Four games is done, let's go somewhere else.
Let's do Potpourri 800.
I've achieved this highest possible single game score twice. And yes, I have the rings to prove it.
Nihilus?
What is 300?
Yes, 300. You did.
Let's do Weird Al songs for 8.
This 2011 medley combines Lady Gaga's Poker Face, Justin Bieber's Baby, Dead or Alive's You Spin Me, and many more into one upbeat polka fuel tune. What is it? Is anybody up? Polka Face, yes. Come and grab it. Niles?
And let's finish off Weird Al for 400.
Fittingly, this 1984 parody of a Greg Kin band song was played when Weird Al lost on the celebrity version of the show. Niles?
What is I Lost on Jeopardy?
How fitting.
All right, let's do Beatles for 8.
Beatles for 800. Its name is derived from a strong man of Greek mythology and, fittingly, can lift up to 850 times its own weight. Percy?
What is a Hercules beetle?
Yes.
All right, last beetle, 400.
For 400, this polka dotted species of beetle has a rather feminine name. Riley?
What is a ladybug?
Correct.
Let's finish off beetle 400. What's that? Oh, I'm sorry, I meant the last category, 400.
My first furry convention was this one in 2003, but only around 800 furries piled into a Chicago area hotel.
Riley?
What is Midwest Fur Fest?
Yes.
Let's do 2000.
2000, what's my number? 86 was his spy codename while working for Control in the TV and film series Get Smart. Does anybody like really old TV shows?
Maxwell Smart!
Yes! Maxwell Smart, come and get yourself something. Riley?
1600.
The answer there is the seventh day double! All right, what are we at? 10,800. What would you like to risk?
Oh gosh, let's only do 800.
Only 800, okay. Here is the clue for you. 24601 was the number given to this prisoner in Victor Hugo's Les Miserables. Riley?
Can't think of it. Who is Jones?
I'm sorry?
Who is Jones?
No, not Joan. Who, I heard someone say Jean Valjean, yes. So you drop a little bit. You drop a little bit just to 10,000, but that is okay. 3 clues left. What is left?
Do 1,200.
011 was the number assigned to this Stranger Things character during the MK Ultra experiments. She was later adopted by Chief of Police Jim Hopper and given this name. Riley?
Who is 11?
No.
L.
Nihilus?
Who is L?
No. Percy doesn't know it. How about the audience?
Jane!
Yes, Jane Hopper. Jane Hopper. Riley?
800.
800. Formerly, he was first officer of the USS Enterprise NCC 1701D. Informally, Picard called him his number one. Audience?
Riker!
Riker, yes. Exactly. And now the 400-point clue. He was Jumba's 626th experiment. Lilo would adopt him and give him this pet name. Nihilus?
Who is Stitch?
Stitch is correct. And that finishes up the Double Jeopardy round. Let's recap the scores. We have Nihilus in third place with 6,200. Riley at 8,800. Percy, well in the lead at 18,600 points. Well, let's reveal today's final Jeopardy category. Why not? Today's category is Furry Entertainment. Furry Entertainment. Let's get our wagers put down, and then we're going to have some extra time for audience questions. Get yourself some more prizes. We'll be right back after this. Okay, you see the scores?
We still have a little bit of time while we get everything straightened out here for Final Jeopardy. So we have a few different questions here for you. Let's see if we can get some of these just, you know, shot in the dark here. Out of the category, same word. What you do to an envelope, or the mammal that can balance an envelope on its nose.
Seals,
absolutely. Come on up, get something out of this backstory. No? You don't want it? Somebody wanted it? I thought somebody wanted it. Ah, I just can't see. That's the problem. I can't see, but I can be out of the category spelling bee with bee quotation marks. A newborn, or what Justin Bieber sings about.
Baby.
What are babies? What are babies? Small, tiny human babies. Let's see, we've got a few other good ones here. There we go. Out of the category, the toy shop. Introduced in 1959, it wouldn't be until 1961 this doll would meet boyfriend Ken.
Barbie
is what we're looking for. Of course! Of course Barbie is what we're looking for. How about, what category is that? Recent films. Can't read, maybe. I can't, let alone see, I can't read. Cillian Murphy starred as the director of the Manhattan Project in this 2023 film of the same name. Ah, we've caught on, have we? Excellent, excellent. And we'll get a little trickier here, Julian. Not too hard. Don't worry, not too hard. We still want to get the prizes out, right? All right, out of the category, Sweet Tooth. In the film Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, this candy that Charlie returns is the only one to actually exist. Yes, and goodness gracious, they
do last forever. Oh my god.
Charities, something all of us furries obviously spend way good amounts of money on. I was gonna say too much, then I realized no, it's not too much. Go donate to the charity after this. But this question is about a different one. Following World War I, they were founded to defend the civil liberties of Americans.
ACLU, I heard.
A couple of you over here to my right, y'all's left, get it. Very good. Very good. And just slightly more modern than that, about 50 years or so, out of the category of video games, so I'm sure a number of us have played a video game before. It Software says hardcore PC games went mainstream in 1994 when it unleashed this fatal sounding game.
Doom 2!
What do we say? Maybe one more, I think? I still got a few more. Oh, good. For more time. Well, why don't we talk about some other fandoms? Category Other Fandoms. On October 10th, 2010, Hasbro launched My Little Pony Friendship is Magic, spawning this fandom. cronies. I've seen a number of them. We had a panel of sticks yesterday, I think, right? Somewhere in there. Yeah, absolutely. Come on. Let me get up here and get some stuff. Out of the category card games, I feel particularly targeted by this one. It's the lowest total that makes you go bust in blackjack. I heard one on each side in like perfect unison. It was beautiful. It's in stereo. Am I running out?
Finally.
No, I found some more. Out of the category famous thirds, he's the face of Anthrocon, Takebushi Goro, or in English, Samurai Cockroach. Uncle Kage. Wherever he is, I dream of being that not sober. From the cinema, back to movies. We haven't had enough movies in this show yet. We hope the odds have been ever in your favor when going to view this film. Hunger Games, I heard about 17 voices from this side, then 38 more on this side. I love it. See? Fun fact, I'm reading these off of our test exactly to try out for Jeopardy. So all of you are proving you can do this. Means what? I'm blind? And they let me on this show twice? I don't understand why. And it is lunchtime, so let's eat. It may be Greek to you, but it's a minced lamb meat served in a pita, topped with a cucumber yogurt sauce. Yeah! God, I'm hungry! Yes, it is absolutely a gyro. Come on, grab some stuff.
Well, it's a good thing this show is ending soon because it's time for Final Jeopardy. Are we all done with the audience questions? Well, we got a little time asking.
All right. Well, don't know if I'm gonna make it to karaoke or not tonight, so I'm gonna take my chance at singing right now, haha. The category of chorus line. We'll give you a line from the song's chorus, you tell us the title of the song. Good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing this will be the day that I die. Get up here and take another prize. For American Pie, excellent answers.
All right. Well, thank you, audience. You all did great. You all did fantastic on a lot of those questions that our players missed. So if I had a hat, it'd be off. If he had a hat, I think it'd probably be off too. We now come to Final Jeopardy. Percy's in the lead by 18,600 points. That's his score. So let's find out what today's clue is, players. She's Blitzo's adopted daughter and works as a receptionist for Immediate Murder Professionals, IMP. Start writing, 30 seconds. So Nihilus will be losing something. What's the wager? $61.99. Nihilus drops down to only 1 point. Riley, you were second place going in. The response was, who is Vixen? That's not correct. The wager, $8,800. Riley drops to zero. Percy could not be caught. Let's see what Percy wrote down. The correct response, who is Luna? And the wager, 1 point. Doesn't matter, Percy is our first place winner. And now, all three of you come on over here. It's time for your prizes. Bo will tell you about your prizes in just a minute.
Right.
Okay, I'm not cool. What? Everything is awesome with these Lego minifigure blind bag collectibles. What's he got? There he's got. You'll receive two of those blind bags to start your collection. Collect them all. Nihilus, you'll receive the Lego minifigure blind bags plus. Let your wild side out with this official Big Wild Plush Doll. Dressed in your favorite outfits from Zootopia and more, each sold separately. Percy! Not only will you receive the Lego blind bags and the Big Wild Plush Doll, but you'll also get a chance to catch them all with this 10-piece Pokemon figurine set. Start your journey with several great Pokemon from several great generations. And as a bonus prize, have you heard of the soundtrack of the critically acclaimed MMORPG Final Fantasy XIV, Endwalker? Well, now you can with the official Endwalker soundtrack Blu-ray disc. All yours is your winning prize today on Jeopardy.
Thank you, Bo. Thank you.
Now, we still have a few minutes before our security kicks us out of this room. So, I mentioned that we do have a very special prize for our first place winner, and Percy, I think that's you. Percy, what do you think of Megaplex this year?
I have been having a blast so far. I have been looking forward to this for months, and it has exceeded all my expectations.
Is this your first Megaplex? Have you been here before?
It's my second. I was here a couple years ago for the first time.
Your first time was a couple years ago, and this is your second time. Percy, are you going to come back to Megaplex next year?
Absolutely.
How about if we gave you a 3-day standard registration to Megaplex 2024 as part of your first place prize package?
Thank you so much. I would love
that. This is a prize that we've been wanting to give away here on Jeopardy since day one. And now, as part of our 5-year anniversary special, we finally get to do it. Percy will be receiving a 3-day standard registration pass to Megaplex 2024 free of charge. Now, you do still have to find a place to stay, you do still have to find a way to get here, and if you want any of the sponsor benefits or goodies, you will have to pay the difference. But if you're happy just to be here at the standard registration level, you are getting into next year's Megaplex for free.
See you all next year, I guess.
And with that, that comes to the end of another Furry Jeopardy. Well, I guess we'll see you for 6 years. Next year at Megaplex 2024. Oh, and by the way, since you're under our 25,000 point limit, if you would like to be a defending champion at next year's Jeopardy, Percy, you may. So, if Percy will be back next year, and I hope he will because he's getting that free registration, he'll be back to defend next year at Megaplex 2024. We'll see you then, and please do take a few extra minutes to watch our credits. We have some really special people that we'd like to thank. Thank you, and we'll see you next year.